The other day, when I was at the shopping mall, I ran into this Aglaonema Maria, more or less. It was sitting under a rock. Somebody had actually put a rock on top of this poor plant. It was a rock about this size, and they had taken it out of a planter box in the mall, and all you could see were little green things coming out of the ends of the rock. Well, I took the rock off the plant, and I took it home and I watered it, and I brought it here to show you today just how sturdy the Aglaonema Maria really is. And as you can see, it does have some yellow leaves on it that are dried up, but for the most part, it really doesn't look too bad. And as evidence of that awful rock sitting on top of it, you can see its pot's all broken and cracked. And I'll have to take this home and repot it really soon. The Aglaonema Maria is now living in my living room, so I don't think that any rocks will be falling on top of it again. Now, as you can see, it's really doing well. It's actually thriving. And I've removed all the old and ugly leaves that it had on it, and I've repotted it into a nice new fresh grower's pot. I do keep it in a nice brass container because I think that also beautifies the house as well as the plants. Now you can see, if you look closely at this plant, the after effects of its trauma. It still has some scars, if you can see some right there, and there are also some scars on this leaf. And over here too, this hole is also a result of the rock falling on it or being put on it. And let's see, it actually has scars on several leaves here. And there's really nothing to do about that. It's just the way it is now, and its new leaves are very nice and healthy. They don't have any scars, except for this one here. This actually, see how it's just got a few little holes right near the tip of the leaf. What happened here is this must have been all folded up, just a brand new leaf at the time that the rock was put on top of this plant, so that the very tip actually got damaged, and as it folded out, it's left this scar on it. And I do have one scar on here, though, that did not come from that traumatic experience, and that's this leaf over here. One day my pet parrot decided to take a walk across the living room floor and to try out this leaf for lunch. Luckily, I caught him before he could do much damage, but this is the result of that. Now, one thing you can do if your leaves do get damaged for whatever reason is go ahead and trim them up. And what I like to do is trim them in the shape of the leaf itself so that when you look at the plant, later, you don't even notice that it had a trimmed up leaf. See, something like that. As the other ones come to a point, then bring your clipped one also to a point. It's really just that easy, and it helps keep your plant looking a little bit nicer. The Aglaonema, obviously, here is a super plant, very hardy, and if you decide to get one for yourself, what you need to do is you can keep it in either low light or a place where it gets a little bit of direct sun, and then let the soil dry out somewhat, about 1 to 2 inches below the soil surface, and give it a good soak when it needs water. It's as easy as that, and they are a super plant. Thanks for joining us, and watch again.